Good morning, friends. Today we are identifying different parts of speech in different sentences. We have studied 8 parts of speech, that is noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, conjunction, prepositions and interjections. By remembering the functions of each one, we can easily identify the parts of speech in the given sentences. Let's start. The first sentence, he has made a beautiful idol. When we read the sentence, the very first word, he. Now the word he, we can use in place of any person, any male person. So that he, it is used for any person. It means it is a pronoun, because we have studied the definition of pronoun, a word which is used in place of a noun. So here he, it is a pronoun. Let's move. He has made a beautiful idol. Here made, it shows action. Action of making something. So the word which shows action, what is it called? The word which shows action or an action word, it is called verb. So this is our figures, our parts of speech, that is verb. Again, move to the sentence, he has made a beautiful idol. Here we can see that idol, idol, it is a word, it is a name of a thing, and a name of a thing, place or person, it is called a noun. So idol, it is a noun, that is our third part of speech. Now this beautiful, when we look at this word beautiful, he has made a beautiful idol. This beautiful word, that tells something about what? Is it telling about he? Pronoun? No. Is it telling about the verb made? No. The word beautiful, it tells something about the noun idol. So remember, a word that tells something about a noun or pronoun in the sentence, it is known as adjective. So here beautiful, it tells something about idol, and idol, it is a noun. So this beautiful, it is an adjective. So see the very first sentence, he has made a beautiful idol. In this sentence, we have 4 parts of speech. He, pronoun, made, verb, beautiful, adjective, and idol, it is a noun. Let's move to the second sentence. Mr. Sharma can speak French fluently. Very first word, Mr. Sharma. It is a name of a person. So Mr. Sharma, it is a name of a person, and a name of a person, place or thing, it is called, yes, it is called noun. So Mr. Sharma, that word, it is a noun as a part of speech. Let's further speak. Mr. Sharma can speak French fluently. Speak, this word, it shows action, action of speaking. So the word which tells, a word which express action, that is called verb. So speak, here it is a verb. Then French, it is a name of a language. So as it is a name of a language, so it is a noun. And the last word, fluently. Fluently. Now see what types of function this word fluently does. When we say fluently, what it suggests or what it expresses, that speak, the action of speaking, that is modified by the word fluently. French, fluently, no. Speaking, fluently. So fluently, that tells something about speak, and speak, it is a verb. So a word that tells something about, or a word that modifies a verb, adjective or another adverb, that is called an adverb. And fluently, it tells something about the verb speak in this sentence. So fluently, it is an adverb. Fluently, that modifies speak, and speak, it is a verb, that is why fluently, it is an adverb. Let's go to the third sentence. Jack and John are playing cricket on the ground. Here we can see that Jack and John, they both are the name of persons. So they are now, because they are name of persons. Now Jack and John, these two name of persons, they are joined by the word and. And we have studied in a parts of speech, the words which join two words or two things, persons, phrases, clauses or sentences, they are called conjunction. So and, here it is a conjunction. Then Jack and John are playing cricket on the ground. Here the word playing, it shows action, and the an action word, it is known as verb. So playing, it is a verb in this sentence. Then a cricket, it is a name of game. It is a name of particular game. So it is here once again noun. Then on, it shows the position. Both the boys, they are playing cricket on the ground. This on, it suggests the position of the action, and it is also related with both the nouns Jack and John. So here it is preposition. Already I have told you that preposition, preposition, a word that shows position. So on, it is a preposition. Let's move to the fourth sentence. Alas, I got very less marks. If you see in the sentence, the very first word, alas, it shows expression, it shows feelings. So a word that shows feelings, that is the parts of speech interjection. The last and the eighth one, parts of speech interjection. So here, alas, it is an interjection. I, we use for replacing name of a person, it means replacing noun, so it is a pronoun. Got, it shows action, so it is a verb. Now see, very less marks, here less, it is an adjective, marks, how much? Less. And this less, it is also modified by the word very. Less, this at less, it is an adjective and it is modified by the word very. If you remember the definition of adverb, a word that modifies a verb, adjective and another adverb, that is called adverb. So here very, it is an adverb. So in this sentence, that alas, interjection, I, pronoun, got, verb, very and adverb, and less, it is an adjective. And see the last sentence, she goes to school with her brother. Here she, it can replace for any female person, so this she, it is our pronoun. Goes, it shows action, so it is a verb. School, it is a name, so it is a noun. With, it shows the relation of subject with the other sentence. It shows the relation of noun or pronoun in the sentence. So with, it is preposition. So these are different parts of speech in the sentences. Pronoun, verb, adjective, noun, verb, adverb, all eight parts of speech, they are explained here. We have to see the function of the words which are underlined in the sentence or which are underlined in the paragraph as a part of question. See the function of each word and identify whether it is noun, whether it is pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, conjunction, prepositions or interjection. First read the sentence, focus on the word, that what types of function they are doing in the sentence, and according to it, identify or name the parts of speech. I hope you have understood. So in the assignment, you will be given some of the questions based on parts of speech in which you have to identify various parts of speech. Thank you.